Hi guys, welcome back to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir. Welcome to another YouTube tutorial video, and in this video we'll be learning how to create a digital business card using Elementor Pro. So your digital business card will look like this, where you'll have your nice looking picture with the name of yours and the title, whatever you do, your contact info showing up here, and your portfolio and the work portfolio which you have. And on the bottom we have the contact for WhatsApp, email, phone. So if someone clicks on that, it will direct them to the specific WhatsApp, email or phone which you will add. So if you want to learn, stick to the tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe the channel, which will motivate me to create more good quality content for you guys. Okay, without further ado, let's jump into the back end. Okay guys, our Elementor page is open now. First thing you need to do is go to settings and select your page layout as Elementor canvas, and then we'll add our container. Okay, here we have our container. Now we will add another container within that for our portrait image. So drag and drop another container. For the parent container, select the width as 500 pixel and min height to be as 100 VH. Okay, now for this container we will add our image for the social card which we are designing. So go to style tab, click on background type classic, and then add in any portrait image which you have. So I'm gonna add this one. Okay, cool. Now the minimum height I'll set to be as 350 pixel. Okay, looks good so far. Go to style, and for size select it as cover, and position should be center top, which will look a little good on my side. Okay, select no repeat as repeat. Okay, cool, looks good. Now we'll add a little background overlay to make it a little more attractive. So click on background overlay on style tab, select gradient, and in gradient the first color to be white and completely transparent. So scroll it to the start, and here we have the transparent color. For the second color we will select as black. Okay, now location, make it linear, radial. I guess linear looks good. We can adjust the angle, and we can adjust the opacity as well. For angle, I guess 90, 60, 180. Okay, that one looks fine. Reduce a little opacity on that. Okay, now the second thing which we will do, we will add our headings. Drag and drop the heading element from widgets. So Bilal Nasir, I'll add my name, style it, add the text color white, and typography, let's pick up a little cool font. I'm going to select the able, which looks nicer to me. Okay, clone it, duplicate it, and then select the heading tag to be h4. Okay, let's see, and in this we'll name it web developer. Cool. Now click on container from navigator, the second container, the photo container which we created, and from there click on items and select flex end. Okay, looks good, right? Okay, now let's add in another container below that for okay, a little issue with the drag and drop, I guess. Okay, perfect. We have the container below. For the background for the parent container, I think the black color will look good. So click on style for the parent container and select your background color as a darker one. And I think black will look good. Ah, that looks fine. Okay, now we will add some padding for our second container. Go to the second container style, click on advanced and add in some padding, like 40 pixel would work. Nope, 20 pixel. Yep, that looks much better. Okay, now for the second container, for the third container which we added, add in the top margin to be negative so it can there will be no gap in between. So I'm going to add minus 20. Yep, that looks fine. Minus 20 looks completely fine. Select the container, go to style tab and add in the gradient color. Okay, green or blue, I guess blue will look much better though. Yep, that looks fine. Okay, now go to your widgets and drop in the icon list. In this, we will add our number to be, okay, I'm just gonna add in my number here. It's the dummy number to be, it's not the actual number which I have, so don't try to contact on that one. Okay, location will be my city and country. Yeah, that's one is the correct one. I actually live here. Okay, and that will be my website. So click for website. So I'm just gonna add the link for the website. Okay. Now for this, I'm going to add a link. No need to for this one. For website, I'm just gonna add in the link for my actual website. Okay. Now I'm going to style it a bit, add the same padding which we added on the top one. So what was the padding which we added? So 20 pixel, the same padding I'm going to add on this one. Click on advanced and then add in the padding. Okay, we have added the padding. Now we will add the media carousel for our portfolio item. So search for media, drag and drop the media carousel. Okay, we were supposed to drag and drop within that, so. Okay, here we are. Now I'm going to add some relevant pictures for this. Okay, so let's add in the media carousel images. So I'm going to upload some of the images. Yeah, that one is looking a little weird, so I'm gonna remove that. Okay, see, these three images looks good. Now what I'm gonna do to make it a little stylish, we'll be adding left and right margin in minus. So left and right. Now you can see it's taking us out of the container. Now for that, we will select our container and from layout on overflow section, we will select from default to hidden. Looks nice, right? Cool. Last but not the least, we'll be adding our social media icons. Social, here we go. Okay, so just drag and drop it on the bottom. And so let's first add in the WhatsApp icon. Search for WhatsApp, insert, there's a button, and now to link it, select on dynamic tags and then click on contact URL. From contact URL, click here, and here you will see type. We will select WhatsApp and add in the number wherever you wanna take the messages to. I'm just adding the dummy number for now. Okay, and similarly, what we will do, we will do the same icon for our email. So here's the icon which I'll select for the email. Select insert button here. And then we will do the same with dynamic text. Select on contact URL and then again click on that, type, and here we will select mail, and then we can simply type in our email address. Subject, digital card message, digital card message. So I'm just adding in the dummy info. You can add as many social media icons you want. Okay, now I'm going to add one more icon, which is the last one. So that will be the phone. So let's search for that. Insert, and now similarly we'll do the same. Click on dynamic text, select on contact URL, and then from type we'll select tell and add in the number wherever we want to link it to. Okay, again, that's a dummy number, not my own number. Okay, our social media digital card is ready.